trying to all go up here.
No.
Let me say to you as I begin that I have never, never preached at a service such as this is. You know, when we speak about reality as being harsh, well, this is it. This truly is it. This is when reality is harsh. And I wish there was kind of a magic wand which would touch everyone here today and set us free from the profoundly difficult reality which confronts you as much as it confronts me. You know, death in old age, even middle age, is always difficult, but eventually acceptable. The death and dying of children like 8-year-old Edson and his 5-year-old brother Edson simply does not make sense, and probably for some never will. It's right and just. It is truly right and just. It is okay to say, God, we simply do not understand, nor do we want to believe. Help our unbelief. You know, when children never get to live out their childhood or adolescence and move into the fulfilled future which they long for, perhaps even to bring forth their own children, life becomes burdensome and for some unbearable. You will agree with me that Edson and Leson only began to enjoy childhood excitement of making new friends, perhaps sharing secrets between themselves, and beginning to feel importance with themselves and with others. Not even finished playing with their childhood toys, Spider-Man being one among them. To be sure, some of their time as brother to brother was sacred time, perhaps not even noticed by many, as no doubt they shared their joys and their toys, their hopes and their disappointments. But they have been deprived of a future which they may have only begun to hope for. If the human heart has tears, they're flowing like a river today, and perhaps will continue to flow indeed for some time. Given the grief and sadness and even anger surrounding this horrific tragic event, we cannot ever allow ourselves to lose hope in our lives, and especially in those of our children. You know, as difficult and as challenging as these circumstances are, your life and mine only make sense when we allow God to be God, whom we will continue to call upon and rescue us from times fraught with trials and difficulties. Edson and Asaph, you now hear more clearly than any one of us the words of Jesus. Let the little children come unto me. And as they find their place of grace and glory in the presence of God, And as much as our heart yearns after them, we need to be consoled in knowing that God will keep them in His bosom. They will be safe and secure forever. And where they are, we hope to follow, because their joy and their gift of being in God's presence is always something that we ourselves will yearn for and long for and never give up our hope for. And so as these two infant youthful symbols lie in our coffins here today, let them be raised up for us as symbols and signs of hope and security that God will never truly abandon them or us. For God's gifts, for God's grace, that we may struggle through this difficult time and see the face of God in this troubled experience. For God's grace, for God's blessing, for the hope that must continue to reside in each of us, we give the Lord thanks today and we give Him praise.
People sometimes say that I talk too much. Julie tells me all the time. But I had to tell you this morning, I'm at a loss for words. Because I just don't think there are words that can describe the sense of loss and grief that we're all feeling, and just how large this tragedy is in our city and how many people it has impacted. I think that we all try to understand something that we just can't understand, and we struggle with it. Look at the photos of Edson and my son together. And I think if you're a parent, you can't help but think of your own children as you look at them. In my case, I have 5 boys. So if you've lived in a house with boys before, you understand how special that relationship is between brothers. They don't always get along, but they always love each other and they always protect each other. So as I look at this and try to find any hope or blessing in the midst of this terrible loss, I think that there is a blessing that Edson and his son are still together. They're still together. And they're still loving each other and they're still protecting each other. For the past 12 days, I've watched the extent of how much this loss has impacted our city. And to the family, to the friends, it's important that you know how much this has impacted everyone. And I've watched for 12 days. Not even just the school community, but everyone in the city is sharing your grief and sharing your pain and here to support you in any way that you possibly can.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. At this time, I'd like to call Pastor Josephine Arndt, who came all the way out from Charlotte. She's the grandmother of the oldest daughter, and she has a few verses.
Edson and LaSong. As hard as it is, my son, L.A. is after his mom, and the S.O.A. is for me. So they're gonna go be with our father, and we gained two angels, just the way I'm looking at it. And it's hard. Thank you for your support. Thank you very much. Tudo em nós, e se for, nós damos tudo família. Obrigado. Obrigado. Tudo alguém.
Okay. And these two angels, they don't look up after us. Those angels don't have any God. Those angels. So, obrigado.